baby, now I got the flow.
I'm about to pull up. It's wasteful cuts. Yeah, I've been waiting so long. Now I gotta resurface.
Can you guys hear me? Is the mic working? What up, Domino? What up, Jared? Oh, what's up, everyone? We're back with some of the most copywritten music available. We got Lukovic, Waldorf, Janix, of course, Branfrost. I haven't seen you guys in years. Welcome back yourself, guys. Yeah, I would button this up more, but as you guys know, I don't want to. And also the buttons just are off now, so. There's only so much you can do, right? Yeah, look at all these lovely face names. Yo, Domino, do you have mod? Hell yeah. Fuck, I gotta... Domino, if you kick anyone, I'm gonna kick you. Oh, you can pin comments too? Nice. Is that just pinned for me? There's like so many new things going on. Alright, let's get Ryan here. We're gonna be hanging out today. We're talking about the other side. We're talking about Parallel. Lots has gone on since we've been on last. We got some good things cooking up as well, so... excited to get back in it. Glad to see you guys here. Thank y'all for being here. Let's vibe. Let's chill. Gotta figure out my fucking hotkeys again. I also need to put on music that won't get us banned. What's up, dude? Hey, man. we're on. Good, it's a good thing you got rhythm, man. Otherwise, that would have been embarrassing.
I was just feeling the vibes. I could have stayed at that welcome screen all night, honestly.
I love Post Malone.
Woo-wee.
Is he so big Woo-wee. That he's not cool anymore, or is he still cool?
I think he's still pretty cool.
Okay.
Yeah.
Dude, I saw him. He came to University of Idaho when he just after Stony, and I got to see him like in the field. For free. It was awesome.
That's pretty dope.
Yeah, it was really cool. It was like 500 people.
Damn,
it's pretty fun.
That's early.
Yeah, man, I'm really on top of the music, and I liked Post Malone before. Somehow I find people after they released their studio album, but I'm sure someone has found him before that.
I think you were probably first.
You think
and
so?
I think, yeah, all credit is due.
He's my cousin, yeah, dude.
You discovered him.
He's my cousin. Does he look like me? He kind of looks like me.
You definitely could be cousins.
Yeah.
I could see that.
We both have hair and we both have face tats.
Questionable chest hair.
Dude, did you see that?
Got that going.
Did you see that video? Where he was like doing all these like crack moves and like rubbing himself and stuff. And
I did.
Everyone was like, is he okay?
Yeah.
I'm like, that just looks like a good performance to me. Maybe I've done too much crack, but.
He could have been lost in the sauce. He could have been lost in the music too. You know, like I could see it either way.
He was somewhere.
He was definitely somewhere.
Yeah. And I'm here for it, man.
That guy was having a good ass time.
Yeah.
Speaking of good ass times, we're back, baby.
We're back.
Look at us.
Welcome back, Rye.
Man, came out of hibernation. You know what it is? It was winter. We just needed to do a little hibernation.
Yeah.
And now we're ready. You know, I spring is right around the corner. This is the perfect time.
Is it starting to get nice where you're at yet?
You know, it was, and the tulips are blooming.
Yeah.
And then literally today, it was like hail.
Ugh.
New York State was like, sorry.
Dude,
you can't enjoy yourselves.
My absolute favorite part of spring is when it gets nice, and then every year it snows again, and everyone's like, I can't believe this happened. And it's like, it happens every year, you fucking idiots.
Yeah. This is forever.
But everyone,
what are you talking about?
Dude, if I was a cashier, I think I would kill myself and then kill everyone else at the store if I was ever a cashier. I could not.
You gotta hear that shit.
I could not handle that.
Yeah, for sure.
I'm not advocating violence or anything, but like, yeah, that it would be a hypothetical situation that I would be put into. Because
yeah, for sure.
It happens every year, man. Same with daylight savings. Like, I can't believe it's dark/light out right now. It's like, yeah, man, that's how it works.
Yeah. I remember being like an awkward, just like junior designer working at a company and like stepping into the elevator with big wigs on your way into work. Mm-hmm. And like, I don't know what to say. It's like, you talk about the weather and you're like, oh no, I'm that guy. I don't want to be that guy.
So
I hate that guy.
How about the game? You see the game?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. I guess I'll just go kill myself.
Dude, here's what you do. You bring up something incredibly controversial, but don't say an opinion on it. Just ask them their opinion.
Just bring
on
it up.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It works.
Yeah,
how about
those gun rights, huh?
Dude, it works surprisingly well. I do it fairly often just to fuck with people. And most of the time they're like grateful that I'm not talking about dumb shit. Like most of the time they're actually like interested to talk about it. Like whatever it is.
Yeah. I like that. I might have to use that.
You should, dude. Just be like, well, I'm not gonna say what type of controversial conversation I would bring up, but.
But there's definitely some levers you can pull.
Yeah.
You know?
For sure. Well, what are we doing today, dude?
We got 14 people. We're just hanging, yeah, honestly.
We're just going to talk shit and not do anything.
Yeah. Well, I mean, let's recap. You know, like, we've been away. We've been working. Been building rags. Other companies, you know, having fun. And while that was happening, there's been some alpha. There's been some games that have been dropping, yeah, which has long been the goal of this stream, is actually showcasing some of those games and playing them live with people. So,
yeah,
you know, you and I were talking offline, of course. We're letting the people in, a little peek behind the veil. But, you know, it seems like a good time to start, you know, making content again, chatting about all the cool shit that's in development. And, you know, we've been fortunate enough to try a few things too. So we're going to be talking Parallel Alpha, All Waves Weekend, The Other Side Voyage 2. Animo had a really cool update today, I think it was. And then the Watchcom Black Packs. Figured we'd touch all four of those today.
We should definitely touch on the black packs because I have some and I don't know what they do.
Yeah, I gotta do that.
Or I mean, I guess I don't have them. I tried to redeem yesterday and it didn't go through. But I heard you just have to like try a couple times.
Let's start there then. Sure. Why don't we start there?
Okay.
Let's pull that up. So I'm gonna pull up the update and try to find it.
What's their website now?
What's their website?
Missing
these days?
Frontier? Missing Watcher?
Hold on. It is
Discord.
Bear with us, audience. Bear with us.
Don't.
It's thewatch.com. Great URL.
Okay.
That's a goated URL right there.
Let me see if the browser's working.
All right.
Thewatch.com. Thanks, Flapjacks.
Yes, sir. And then here's the tweet, too.
Yeah, no thanks, Ryan, but thank you, Flapjacks.
Fuck. God damn it.
Thanks, dude.
Flap always beats me.
Okay. So here we go. TheWatch.com. Okay.
Look at that gorgeous website.
Is there a picture? Oh, let's do the picture on Twitter.
Look, the branding's on point on stream too. Brought to you by Frontier.
Yeah, there you go. They officially sponsor us. And anything that we say is they are liable for.
Yeah. Yeah. What everything is backed by Watcher.
Yeah. If any lawyers are listening, that's official. I wonder if there's has anyone seen what's
brand
on
is
the,
redeemed.
What's on the bottom here?
What do you mean? On the casing itself?
There's like a
on the graphic.
Yeah, there's like a thing by the 404 on the side. I don't know.
Oh, ooh, ooh. Zoom in on that.
Probably says something. I don't think it says anything cool. But what are these things?
Jeez. Oh, I believe, if I remember correctly, that they are additional, what you call it, blocks, flash blocks, for the actual game itself. So it's an expansion upon the first black boxes.
Okay.
And now we have black packs. So that is what I believe was said in the Discord publicly. I think publicly.
I've heard that they're not, they don't contain cards. Like, I think there's I think there's something else. Like, they're like cosmetics or something.
Okay. Yeah, maybe like the initial plan changed, or maybe I just misunderstood, but I will say, dude, the teasers look so good. The website update looks amazing. The recent teaser videos have been awesome. They really sort of upped it in terms of the communications and obviously, like, you know, keeping us in the loop in terms of their development.
They've done a really good job. It's... Oh, shit, we got a sub. El Bapo.
Hell yeah. Thanks. We're back in.
Yo,
we're back in.
We got subs. Thanks, El Bapo.
Ooh.
Yeah.
Just a little validation is all we needed.
Do you think that, I think that Watcher probably has done the most website redesigns of anyone I've ever seen.
It's true. It's true. It's crazy.
It's like every other week, there's an entire new website.
Yeah. Yeah. They're constantly iterating, which I like. El Bapo, what up, man?
Yeah.
What happened with the... Can you tell us a little bit more about the game itself?
Oh, sure.
The Discord game?
Yeah, so there was a game... What's up, Ruston? There was a game where there were five different levels. You could buy a certain amount of lives, essentially. And then each level was kind of a different task, all culminating in a puzzle. And then... one winner, but that one winner ended up being a conglomerate, like a group of people working together.
I didn't know that.
Mm-hmm. It was
that's fucking cheating.
Yeah,
man.
It was obvious, and his crew won it.
God damn it.
I think that's probably why they're not burning it. Oh, and then that NFT, that one of one NFT, you're able to either burn it for something or not burn it and keep the NFT. And they're not burning it right now.
That's cool.
But I think they should, you know?
It's a key, right? They got a key?
Yeah, it's like the overclock.
Mistress.
Something. The
it's
volatile
like that
key.
It's that key that you got from Loopify that will never be used.
Dude, he keeps telling me, he's like, we haven't forgotten you. And I'm like, I'm pretty sure you've forgotten me, man. I don't know. I mean, maybe he's telling the truth, but
I feel like he's true to his word. I'm genuinely curious about how that's going to be used. I'm genuinely curious about Treeverse in general.
Same. Yeah, we'll have to do a Treeverse episode soon, because speaking of like keeping people updated, Loopify is relentless on updates and blog posts. He's
very good.
He's a machine, man.
Yeah, they got a pretty big team from what I understand.
Oh, so is it like more than just Loop?
Well, I mean, like his social media presence, I can't speak to, but in terms of the actual Endless Clouds team that's developing Treeverse, so I thought at one point he said they had somewhere close to like 30 to 40 people, which is crazy.
Okay. That's a lot.
I'm not saying it's a bad thing. It's just like very impressive that quickly they've amassed that many people.
Sure. My dad just sent me the Black Pack definition, by the way. So it contains different in-game rewards such as black cards and skins. Participants have to go through the gamified NFT initiate. That was the game we're talking about to earn their black packs. So
I mean, I like that they did that. They incentivized people to engage with the whole game.
Yeah.
Well, that was smart.
Yeah. And I mean, honestly, he kept saying it, right? But everyone was like, oh, it's so expensive. I don't know if I'm going to get.
Yeah.
And it's like everyone who played got their money's worth and more.
Yeah.
Like by far. So
100%. 100%.
When are people going to stop doubting the Watcher? Because he literally comes through every time. And a lot of times it's delayed, right? Because he promises ambitious things. And it just makes sense. But he always comes through with more than he should, you know?
I think a lot of it has to do with, and this isn't to knock a lot of people, but if you haven't built a company,
retards.
You don't really, if you haven't built a company, you don't really know all that's required to make it successful. And then also, if you have a team of people that are perfectionists, they might promise one thing, and then when they get to that bar, then they realize like, oh, we can push it even further. We can do even more. So I think there's, and the way that he's operated too, it's been very, very selfless. And he's just wanted to create the best possible platform and game that he possibly could, but also provide value to us, which he does all the time. Like, he literally gives away thousands of dollars in the Discord just for engaging, which is insane.
Yeah, it's crazy.
I don't think people realize that, but like, if you are just active enough in the Discord, you've had so many opportunities to make thousands of dollars just from a server.
Yeah. Dude, I remember when the Lucky Watchers, when those were, you could mint 100%. Those for like what, 0.05 or point one at most. Yeah. And those things were going for like 7 ETH.
Yep.
Like pretty consistent. Like, you know, you could sell at 7 for sure.
Yep. I'm just reading I don't know if you want to show this or not. I can read this off. There was recently a weekly update in the Watch server that breaks down like some pretty, pretty good updates. So I'll just read this off here. We had an exceptional crunch these past couple of weeks on game development. It's been about a small but impactful pivot on the game design that we believe was necessary to make the game as fun and original as possible. To give a couple of examples, you will now be able to equip and create decks of flash blocks from 6 up to 10 plus in a future version. And flash blocks, for those that aren't familiar, were the individual tokens that everyone was minting with the initial black boxes. So you can find those on OpenSea on secondary if you want to look. You can also, I think there's black boxes still available. I don't know if they...
Oh, yeah?
Are they... There was a period of time where they like... Did they nullify them? Like, are they done now?
I have no idea.
I'm going to check and probably confirm.
I knew they were open for a while because, like, Mark was wondering whether or not to sell his back in the day.
That's right.
Yeah, I don't know, though.
Yeah, so I can't confirm that. Maybe take a look or double check if you want to buy one of those. But and then he says, you'll be able to equip up to 3 black cards to create your own playstyle. So I'm assuming that's from the Black Pack. And then many, many more details that have been changed and fine-tuned, notably on the AI. Let's see. Cool. And then we will release a small and private visual build for you, the holders, in 2 weeks. In it, you'll be able to control your Zero, which is another token that you can collect on secondary, on a small parcel of the map and use a flash block. So the point is to share a little look and feel experience of our art and visual direction to you. And he said you've seen it in our teasers already, but it's always nicer when it's right in front of you. And so he said 2 weeks. So that was on March 19th, 6 days ago. So we're like roughly just over a week. And if you have a zero, you should be able to engage with that. So there's a little alpha for you if you're not familiar with the watch or you're not in the Discord. Might be a good time to snag a zero. Mm. Not financial advice. So that's neat.
The zero S is going for a 0.03. And the zero Genesis is 0.01. So
just sort of like evened out.
Did we ever get confirmation on
what?
On like the difference between these? One's like a lifetime pass and the other one's more than a lifetime pass, right?
Yeah, Watch Maxi could probably, even though we are too, but I just don't remember the exact details on the differences between the two of them.
Yeah. So it sounds,
you're right,
it sounds like in that post he's saying we can play like an alpha build, basically like a small alpha build.
Yeah, like a slice, more or less.
Yeah, that sounds sick. I can't wait for that.
What up, Malamber? Cool. So that's the latest and greatest on the watch. So we got to look out for that. Mm-hmm. Yeah, dude, I love those graphics. Like the kill animation is so good.
The one so is that the dude. One with like the Viper over the top and it's like lightning. That that one's
exactly.
Sick.
They really fine tune a lot of those little details. And this is the style of game that is like right up my alley. I love this like Command and Conquer, Red Alert type vibes.
Yeah. It's gonna be. Do you think it's gonna be like turn based?
I don't know. Maybe it has to be.
Yeah, I don't know. I would assume it's energy. Probably going to be turn-based, but...
I think it might be.
If it's real-time, that'd be interesting, too.
Yeah.
It looks good. It looks like that nice balance of simplicity and you know, like a really advanced rock, paper, scissors, right?
Exactly.
Yeah, those are some of the best. Oh, yeah, and Domino's right on point. Watcher plays a lot of LOL, so...
Oh yeah, that's right.
I know there's going to be some League of Legends in this. There's three that's lanes, right?
He's competitively like internationally ranked, if I remember correctly.
Oh, is he on like a team, like a pro team, or?
I just remember like early days of Discord, him revealing that he was like legit one of the top players.
Mm. That makes sense.
Yeah.
Yeah, he's definitely good. So like, well, and I mean, honestly, like just take a step back and like Ubisoft doesn't partner and promote anyone. So there's got to be something 100%. Going on here, you know?
Yeah.
Especially because like for a while you could kind of ride the coattails of NFTs and the craze. But just recently he said that Ubisoft basically like redoubled their deal and said that they're going to like, personally help promote and stuff, and so that like that's not just like a ghost relationship, and that's past the NFT prime, so they've obviously got something great going on.
Honestly, I'm kind of glad that Ubisoft got that whatever that partnership that they had that went so poorly. Remember that they got all that backlash from the community?
They just
I'm glad that they got that out of their way. Yeah, Tom Clancy, thanks Tom.
Yeah, they just like said they were doing NFTs, and that was like that was the peak of the furry outrage when everyone
was like, that's right.
But the environment. It's like, yeah,
but in hell,
we understand, guys.
Yeah, so I'm hey, like we're through that gauntlet. Yeah, now we're on the other side, and someone who just posted it. It was like I think it was Wrong Nebula. I just retweeted it today. Yeah, it was like a great post about like Web3 games coming out on the other side and like look past Yuga basically. Mm-hmm. Look at all the foundations, look at all the studios that are in development right now with like Shrapnel and obviously Parallel because we talk about them all the time. But
yeah,
just like the good examples that are currently out there in terms of development and fun, like addictive shit. You know, I think a lot of people are going to be really surprised. Dead Drop, totally forgot about Dead Drop. That's like one of the premium examples.
I don't even know about that. Dead Drop?
Oh, Dr. Disrespect? Dead Drop?
Oh, okay. I've heard of the Dr. Well, Disrespect one, but I didn't know its name.
Yeah, it's gone like parabolic. Like people are absolutely, oh, Dom, come on. I wish I would have done that. I mean, I was smart enough to know that it probably had great support given his brand and all the people that love him. I mean, I just didn't follow through that. I totally slept on it.
Yeah.
But people have been going apeshit for it. And I've seen interactions with Web3 game streamers talking to in-game players about whether or not they give a shit if there's NFTs that are incorporated in the game. And they've recorded like little interactions and snippets with other players, and people, one, don't give a shit, and two, like don't care in sense of like it's a negative.
Yeah.
And two, are interested in collecting the NFTs once they've unlocked them. So it's a perfect Trojan horse.
Mm-hmm.
And I think any of the games that we're all, you know, we talk about consistently, so long as they're free, accessible, and they create really interesting incentives, it's like a no-brainer. Like it completely changes the paradigm. And I don't know how the gaming industry doesn't start giving a shit about it and starts to actually accept it. I think the stigma is going to wear off.
I know it's an kind of an old example, but really Reddit was just so much of a proof of concept for yeah. Trojan horsing NFTs in a way that makes sense for your community.
100%.
It's like, it's nothing but better for the customer if you do it right.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
Yeah. And it's not even talking about like the market aspects of it and actually owning your assets. There's just a lot that NFTs offer as just a base tool for brands. And I'm excited to see more and more of that, because we've been saying since the beginning, like the end of it is going to look like NFTs just being integrated seamlessly into, mm-hmm. you know, customer experiences. And that's where you're really going to get benefit and no downside.
Absolutely. I do wonder how, I don't know if you saw the recent Fortnite announcement and trailer that happened this
SpongeBob
week.
SpongeBob and Cardi B, is that the one you're talking about?
Is that what happened?
Yeah. No, it sounds oh like my it God. Could happen though, right?
Yeah, we're dropping Patrick Starr, dude.
Patrick Starr concert.
He can shoot bubbles out of yeah. his tentacles
live with Simon Cowell.
What the Simon yeah. Simon Cowell's melted face from plastic surgery. Yeah, you can unlock his other faces.
The first 100 buyers get a free baby tank top.
It's like, holy shit. Like Fortnite, I really fell for it.
Fortnite's off like, the fucking rails, man. Like, it's kind of admirable though. It's like they just go full goof, like shill mode, and people love it.
Bro, you hit me with a Goku Piccolo, like when they added that, the Nimbus, I was like, I'm in. Like I'm so back.
Yeah, why not? It was like how Smash Bros. Was in the day.
Oh my God, exactly. Dude, exactly.
Before Smash Bros., no one even thought about putting all your favorite characters into a game and having them like right? battle or something. And that game
must
was
have been like a licensing, like absolute licensing mayhem to do it.
I'm sure. Well, they were so competitive with, well, I guess they were all in Nintendo properties. So I wonder.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
Maybe
not then.
Yeah. They were so competitive with other brands that they for sure couldn't have got anyone else in at that time. But
mm-hmm.
yeah, I just remember seeing the commercial with like Yoshi bashing people with a hammer, and they're all in these like giant puppet costumes spinning around in a forest. And I remember thinking this is going to be the best game of all time.
Yeah. And yeah, how can you ignore that?
Pretty much was, man. It's a pretty good game.
Still holds up to this day. OG.
What do you think is going to be like? Well, it's hard to say, right? I want to talk about Parallel.
Let's get into it.
I'll answer my own question three steps down the line and just say, let's just talk about Parallel, because we both...
It's on your mind.
We both have been in the alpha, and it's really good.
Yeah, and we're leaking everything. We're breaking NDA right now.
Yeah, yeah. Try and find me, lawyers.
Big can't. Parallel will never.
I'm using a VPN, dude. You can't find me. You'll never be able to find me.
Kalos is outside right now. Got that red dot.
Yeah. Okay. Why aren't we sponsored by NordVPN or something? They give sponsorships to everyone, dude.
I use it. I love it. I'd love to chat with you, Nord. I really do use it.
Holy shit, dude.
Yeah, Lord. See, they're everywhere.
That's why it says you're in Switzerland right now.
Oh, shit. Ted's in town. Ooh, Ted. Let's go.
What up, Ted?
Big chest hair vibes.
That's true, dude. I need one of those Italian sperm necklaces.
I got one, bro.
Do you?
I'm a living
go,
fucking...
Let's go.
I'm just pure satire over here. My parents went to Italy, and then I'm Italian. I'm half Italian. And they got it, and I was like, oh, I got to wear it, right? Yeah. Like, I'd be rude not to. But I also realized these are the guys that I made fun of in high school. So I'm also that guy.
Yeah, it's because you wanted to be them, though, you know?
Maybe.
How many people, in retrospect, are you like, I was just jealous, I guess?
Dude, I was actually never jealous. I was like, those are the worst people. Are the worst people.
You just haven't been enlightened yet.
We get it. You're Italian.
You'll be on your deathbed and you'll be like, fuck, he was cool. I should have gone shirtless more.
I probably would have lived longer if I had more gobble ghoul. I didn't ingest enough.
Oh, that's so good.
My goodness.
I'm not Italian, so I don't think I can wear one.
It'd be pretty funny if you did, though.
It would be a vibe.
With that whole arrangement that you got going on right now, yeah. You'd fit in.
I can...
My grandfather would bless you with his ragu.
Well, I might have to go buy one then. That sounds like something I can't pass up. But let's get on the parallel train. Like, what have you thought about the Alpha so far? It's been about a month, right?
Pretty lame, man. Really don't. I like when I go to bed at night, I don't think about it. When I wake up, I definitely don't think about it. I don't think about the mechanics of the cars. I don't reach out to you ever and talk about how I can improve my decks. I never do that.
Dude, we'll just randomly start like message each other and be like, hey, I added this card in my deck. And it's like a one card difference. And it's like, fuck, I gotta try that.
Have you thought about that whole thing? Yeah. Well, listen, we got the go ahead from Gon to talk about it. We're not going to show anything other than what's currently public and on the website.
Yeah.
But I mean, the best thing you could possibly do, we'll talk about the Alpha in a second, but best thing I feel like people can possibly do is go to the deck builder and tinkering around. I think you're on the card viewer. If you go to tools. Deck builder.
Nice.
Yeah. And then you should be able to throw some stuff together.
Oh, these are my decks.
It did pull them in. So I don't know if you can show that or not. Anyone can build their own. Don't show your deck, dude. We might get cease and desist. Yeah.
They look so good.
Like he's yoked. Absolutely yoked.
I want Shoshana to win. But
she's a good paragon for sure.
Gafar is just so good.
Zero paragons. You know what's really funny is you in banter in the server, you rep so hard for your faction, just for like trolling, shits and giggles, whatever, you know? And then you get access to the Alpha, and now I love like all the parallels. I love them all equally.
Yeah.
And the personality of each one is so varied and so thoughtful. And the play style is so different. And obviously the card mechanics are all different too. But like how you balance them, how you use them. And we were talking earlier about like the nuance of making a deck, tweaking it, using it, learning it. Because like even when you like have a few matches, you still don't really know like all the scenarios, and you're just sort of like feeling out the flow of each deck that you're using, except Katharia. Yeah. Yeah, there's some like balancing that's occurring.
I was gonna say, like, I don't love every parallel equally.
I like playing it.
So if anyone's ever played Magic, like there's very clear factions, and they have very clear game plans within those factions, and there's lots of flex in between. There's things that you can do to bring in like universal cards, but the game plan and the paragons are like really, really cool. Like that depending on which Paragon you play, that completely changes the game.
Yeah.
They all have their just different flavor though. It's just, you know, it's so nice to like 100%. You know, speaking of Italy, I'm gonna make this sauce, you know, it's gonna be a pesto sauce and then it's gonna be a white sauce, and it's like it's all sauce, but you like depending on the base you use, it's gonna be completely different.
Yeah. And they all, in terms of how they've orchestrated the decks as they play one another, it makes sense. Like, I'm not saying anything profound, but the way in which they feel when you play against a different faction, like everything is just enjoyable to play. Well, you know, like you said, like maybe there is some parallels that are less enjoyable to play against. But I just mean like the stylistic and the personality between like different factions battling each other are really genuinely interesting.
Yeah. What's the worst one? What's the worst parallel to play against right now?
Oh, like the toughest?
Well, no, just the one that nobody likes.
Well, it started...
It's Marcolian. It's for sure Marcolian.
I thought it was Kath, honestly.
Yeah, they're pretty tough. Yeah. Like, there's a deck in each parallel that is very powerful. And there's kind of like, you know, we were talking about rock, paper, scissors earlier. Like, there is some aspect. You got rush decks, you got tempo decks, and then you've got control decks, right? And those round robin, and each one of those parallels has like a strong deck. It's just, yeah, I'd say, dude, for alpha, and we were talking about this before we came on, like for alpha, most polished alpha I've ever seen. And
it's unbelievable.
It's like an actual fun game, and it's just the first test, you know? So
yeah,
I can't wait.
The honest reaction to your first question, now that we've been talking about it for just 10 minutes, is like, it is as addictive as any game I've ever played. I genuinely think about it all the time. I want to play it all the time. I'm blown away by the fact that it's an alpha, and I cannot even imagine what the beta is going to be like. Which, by the way, if you're not familiar with the game at all, the beta is out in July. I believe that there are signups right now if we want to help the people out. I think it's parallel.life/early-access, and that gives you a sign up. I don't know if it's going to reveal anything because we're in the alpha. I don't know if it reveals like a different page because we're in the alpha, but I'm pretty sure it's /early-access. So sign up if you're really interested in playing the game. Highly recommend building a deck on the website. Let's see, early access. Let me just put it here and click
dude,
it.
Dude, this dude looks like Bible Man.
I love that guy.
Do you know who Bible Man is?
No, oh. I don't. I just love that Paragon.
Okay. It just came to me.
Let's get this side by side. Oh my god,
dude, he's like the same.
It's amazing.
It's like the same person.
Is this like a god like or Christian based superhero that's been created?
Hell yeah, dude, and it's so cringe.
Oh my god, it's amazing.
Oh, that's so funny. Yo, we got to take this and put his head.
Oh, that's so good.
There's some photoshopping so to be done.
Where's Dave when we need him?
Yeah, Dave, get on it, man.
Dave, we need you, bro. Holy shit. I did not know that reference. That's like uncanny.
That's so good.
Talk a little bit more about the banking system for people that don't know about it. And also like maybe how it compares to an older traditional TCG like Magic.
For sure. So the way that... it's called energy in this game, right? In Magic, it's land, which is turn you tap for mana. In Hearthstone, it's like, I think it's just mana, right? It's crystals. But basically, like every game has a way that you pay for the cards that you play. And in this game, there's what's called the bank. And honestly, I think it's one of the coolest systems in card games, like ever. for sure since like Magic. It's so good. So
I love it.
What you do is you put, in order to gain energy, you once per turn, you can put a card from your hand into the bank, and that will give you an energy moving forward. You know, that stays in the bank and it will provide you energy every turn.
Yeah.
If you do that, then you get a card, you get an extra draw at the end of your turn to replace that card. If you choose to not do that, then you don't get an extra card at the end of the turn. So basically, you have to look through your hand, and instead of waiting like in Magic, you have to wait for lands so that you can play them and then get mana. In Hearthstone, you just get one per turn unless you're playing a different card that ramps you or something. But this is the best of both worlds, where you're not going to get flooded or not get any mana, because you always have the option to put a card in your bank. But in the early game, you can put high cost cards in your bank, and at late game, you can put low cost cards in your bank. And it's just so flexible in giving you power in your deck and kind of smoothing out that curve that comes with like, I need to draw X, I need to draw Y. You've always made a choice where, like, I've run into a few times where you put a low cost card in the bank, and then that low cost card would just like do exactly what you needed to late game. But you're like, okay, well, I had to do that to get the mana. So the dynamic there is super interesting.
The beauty for me is the tension of those decisions, because there's a lot of strategy in what you choose, obviously, like you're talking about. And it really, I mean, you have a timer, you know, like you're deducing what they're doing, what they're going to do next, what's coming down the pipe in terms of your deck, and also what you're going to, you know, essentially bank and get out of hand. And that like conflict, that negotiation that you have to make with yourself every single turn is really fucking fun. And like you said, like it doesn't really exist, right? Like there's no, are there any TCGs that use that?
The bank, like a banking system?
Yeah.
Not really. I mean, most TCGs either are reliant on a draw to get mana, or it just automatically happens and everyone's on the same path. So,
yep.
I mean,
yep.
As far as I know, this is like one of the only, well, and from what Koji said, like this is kind of what they started from, where they, you know, they're nerds. So they were playing other card games, and like the core was this fix in the mana system.
Yeah, and it's so good, man.
It shows.
It's so good.
Yeah, it's great.
So from all of those mechanics in game to the actual formatting and expression of the alpha, and just how polished the alpha is to. And everything that they think about from an ecosystem perspective as well, they continue to be a leader in the space. That's why we always harp on it. It's easy to be excited about it because you can see the level of execution. And they also have a history of building companies too. Like, I think that's very important.
Sure.
I'm not saying that first time founders can't do it, but you know, having gone through the fire a few times, like it does make a big difference. And then having that sort of expertise is very important. So yeah, man, they're killing it. I cannot wait for the beta. I really like, I'm excited for other people to see it, because
yeah,
we've been very lucky that we've gotten to experience it now. And it's painful because we keep telling our friends and family, like, it's like truly like this is amazing, but they can't see, it's not tangible yet.
Mm-hmm.
And once they get their hands on it, I think it's going to go absolutely bonkers.
I think so too. What do you think about, I know card games are a little bit meaty for some people.
Yeah.
What do you think about the skill curve and about, because Hearthstone was so successful because it is easy.
Yeah.
I mean, it's still a card game, right? There's strategy, but like to get in, it's like, okay, look at the numbers and the numbers interact correctly. It's pretty easy to get a match going, right? Magic sure. is notoriously one of the harder games to learn, just because you need to learn the order of operations in order to play at all. And mm-hmm. it's a very complicated order of operations. It's not once you get it, but that system is big enough where you have to learn quite a bit. Like, what do you think about the ease of accessibility with this game?
Yeah, I have a few thoughts. I remember seeing, what do they call it? Like the black box, build, like the very early build of the game at NFT NYC. And Oso, who's on the team, was nice enough to like guide me through a game against Bobbin of all people, who's like one of the best players right now.
Yeah.
And I was like, so lost, dude. He was like explaining things and I was like, I do not understand. Like I walked away from it and I was like, I am the dumbest person in this room. I don't know why I don't understand this. And then going into the alpha client, initially that curve felt incredibly steep. Mm. I will say, I don't think we can like talk about the tools that they offer alpha players or players in general in the client to help assist you in like getting better or learning.
Okay.
But I will say that there are tools that were developed that are mindful of that. And I think that that's a core part of feeling confident and comfortable with what is a complex game and making you feel like you can accomplish it. And then I also think that the reward is that much more satisfying when you start to get wins, because you know how, like, it is very complicated at first.
Yeah.
And then once you start to get a rhythm, or once you start to learn like how certain cards work together, it's very addictive. So I think that's also where an aspect of the addiction comes in, those dopamine hits, because of what you have to do to earn those wins and start to understand the cards. And I think if it was like Hearthstone and it's too easy, then replayability or maybe just like the satisfaction that you get out of play doesn't feel as steep or rewarding. The mountain's not as high to climb.
Hearthstone, it lost its juice pretty quickly, I feel like.
That's what I mean.
Because it was so simple. And then they started injecting RNG into the game to make it more exciting. But what it did was it made the game not fun. It just kind of broke the game, because all of a sudden your match is reliant on a coin toss going your way or not going your way. And you've just played half an hour and the culmination is a coin toss. Like, that sucks really bad.
Yeah, that does suck.
And so I think that Parallel is in, I mean, that's why Magic is so good. That's why it's lasted so long, right? Because it's very complex. And card games in general, like, part of the fun is building decks, you know, is reading cards, thinking about interactions. Like, that's just inherent in card games. And so I think that Parallel's done an awesome job hitting that sweet spot of complicated enough that it's not going to lose longevity, but simple enough where you can understand it with a small amount of effort and you can get into it. It's obviously not Candy Crush, but it's not inaccessible by any means. Like, I don't know. I'm just so happy about it.
Same, dude. Yeah. Same. I am doing a little social media-ing to get the word out that we're chatting, but...
Okay. How much longer do you want to go? Like, another half an hour? Talk about the other side?
Yeah. Sure.
Make this a 3-block show?
Yeah, let's do it.
How's everyone in chat doing? Can I get a vibe check?
One's in chat.
Yeah, one's in chat if you're vibing. Two's in chat if you're kniving.
Three's if you're thriving.
Three's if you're thriving. And four's if you're bored.
Man, one and a half. That's not even...
It's not an option.
Oh, my fucking God.
Three's if you're thriving. Nice.
Janix, no.
Oh, you guys are making me so fucking angry right now. It's not funny to do a different number than the ones that we said.
Domino, get guys, that ban hammer out.
Yeah, Domino, ban anyone who put a number outside of, well, I can't say 1 through 4 because 1.5 is 1 through 4. A whole number outside. There's no crows, Waldorf. I'm sorry. The camera's still up, but like, it doesn't work.
It doesn't work.
Well, I mean, like if I got like a new proper camera,
these gruel chunks, man.
But the GoPro, dude, it like doesn't work most of the time and for no reason. And I could not figure out how to make it consistently work.
You know what we need?
Money.
We need NordVPN to sponsor a camera.
I bet. How do we get? Do you think Mr. Nord has like a number on Twitter or something? I don't know.
I think we can find him.
Because he obviously sponsors everyone else. So I think it probably wouldn't be that hard to get a deal with him, you know?
Dude, we did the digging. We figured out that there's a sixth parallel. If we can do that, I know that we can find John Nord.
Mm-hmm.
There's no doubt in my mind. Or John Nord Jr.
John Nord Jr. is hooked on cocaine, man. We're not. If we find him, it's really not that much of a step forward.
And can you blame him though? He was born into an empire.
No, of course not. I mean, if I was born into an empire, I would be hooked on cocaine too.
Yeah. Might not be my first choice.
That's why I hate my parents, dude.
I'd probably go Quaaludes.
You think you'd do Quaaludes recreationally?
Yeah. I just want to feel that numbness, you know what I mean? That full body numbness.
I'm not going to go too far into the Quaalude joke territory, but I think you're putting yourself in a situation that you might not want to be in if you're taking Quaaludes on the regular.
You shit your pants, is that why?
Just go out to a bar and take a Quaalude and just see what happens, man. Roll the dice. I like live dangerously.
Yeah, he's got a delay or not. We're going to find out.
All right, man. Well, let's get into the other side. I want to... Is it up and running right now, or are we just chatting about it?
No, man. I'm salty. I'm pretty salty about it.
Yeah?
Yeah. So this is what happened. Yeah. Okay, I'm just going to break it down from a person that was not fortunate enough to get in on Voyage number 2.
You didn't get in?
No.
Oh.
It fucking sucked. I thought the whole thing, I know a lot of people got in. It was like, what, 72,000 concurrent players, which is crazy because it was via web browser. You could only play in Chrome.
Shit.
Okay. I was on Chrome. I was in the queue for over a fucking hour. Every time it let me join, it crashed. So, like, I could just never get in.
Mm-hmm.
And then you could watch the stream. So I was just watching the stream, checking it out. And, yeah, I mean, I don't know. Like, what Fortnite just announced basically made me more excited for their metaverse than anything that Yuga could build. And maybe I'll eat those words. I don't know. But I'm 100% selling my other side deed after this stream.
Oh, shit. Really?
I don't, I'll take 2 ETH over, like,
yeah.
Like, people were, like, shitting on it because, like, 6 months was the difference between Voyage 1 and Voyage 2, and it was, like, essentially the same thing.
Oh, was it? I don't know hardly anything. I
need more. I need to see more progress in 6 months.
I said no to the initial mint, and I've been checked out and salty ever since. So,
yeah. So that's just me. Okay. I'm sure there's some people in chat or someone that might watch this later, and they're like, totally, you know.
We should get.
They're not seeing it.
Well, we probably can't get. I was saying maybe we should get Grimecraft on, but I doubt he can talk about it much. I'm sure he's pretty locked down with.
Oh. I'd like to hear his perspective.
Yeah, I just don't want to get. I don't want to get him in trouble if he.
What does he do? What does he do there?
He works on the other side.
Like he's a game developer.
I don't know his exact title.
Okay.
I just know he said he's. Well, you know, he's a long-term metaverse guy, right? Like, he was one of the first people doing VR streams on Twitch, and he's like a real, like an OG in like pushing tech boundaries. So,
well, respect.
Yeah, so he's on that team, and I don't know. I don't know. Maybe I should reach out to him to see if he like wants to talk or if he's locked down or whatever.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, I'm sure there's like some stuff that he could talk about within reason.
Sure.
I couldn't get in, so I'm a little salty about it, but I'm sure that there's a vision. I'm sure that they're building really cool shit and games. to me, as a collector, I'm just trying to consolidate my focuses anyways. So I wanted a little exposure on that side, but I feel like I'm pretty happy with being involved with like Parallel, The Watch, Frontier, Animo. Forgotten Ruins has a game that's coming out very soon that it looks awesome. I'm very excited about it.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, like I want to make sure that if you divvy up your focus in too many areas, I'm not going to be effective as a collector and as like someone that can optimize like profits. Oh yeah. And Treeverse too, of course.
Mm-hmm.
So I don't know. I'll roll 2 ETH into like Parallel Comics and Shards and shit like that.
Yo, yeah. Shards is going to, I need to learn more about Shards. We should have like a dedicated episode on the non-game doings of Parallel sometime.
Probably should. Well, so the comics, like, let me see. I got them in my calendar so I remember.
Before we move on too, like, I just want to say, so I don't think this is salt, but maybe it is. Like, so just take it with a grain of salt, but. I see what I did there. but I don't like Bored Apes. Like, it feels like Supreme back when it was like popping, right?
Yeah.
It's not cool. It's like this.
It's not cool.
It's like this giant, like, douchey version of what some people think is cool. I don't know. Like. Yeah. Everything about it just feels cringe to me. But
I agree. I've always felt that way about it. I've been very vocal about my hate for Bored Apes.
Yeah.
And I genuinely think that they've created a lot more issues than maybe good when it comes to like how normies and like more traditional folks look at NFTs. Mm. So I think it's basically to anyone that's not native to all the degeneracy of the last 2 years, they see it as like complete scams.
Yeah.
Like true. Yeah. Yeah. What Ted said. So
yeah, Ted gets it.
I'm not going to say it out loud.
Ted understands.
Yeah. But yeah, I like my taste for it is soured because of its affiliation. However, as someone who appreciates good brands and brands that develop and innovate, Yuga is doing some really cool shit when they rolled out Other Side, you know, Jimmy the Ape, like all those, like Dookie Dash, I know got a lot of heat too, but like as they are establishing entities under their IP, it is impressive. Then again, they have like so many hundreds of millions that they're working with too, so it's not right. Like, I don't know. Like, I guess in that regard, like you can hire the best talent in the world too when you have that much capital that you're leveraging as well. You just got to know what to do with it.
Sure.
But yeah, it kind of sours it a little bit too because of its affiliation. I feel what you're saying.
Yeah.
But so yeah, Other Side, a lot of people had fun. They had four teams. They basically had to go ahead and collect like these color orbs. And they like brought them to these like battle toad creatures, and then whoever won got an airdrop of like a helmet. So I'm assuming that helmet can be used in the metaverse.
Okay.
And then anyone that participated, I think, got a separate airdrop. And I don't know if anyone that got locked in the queue also got it for participating.
Mm.
But that's basically what it was. They had like a main waiting area that you could just like jump and chat and do a lot of like different acrobatics. And then you went to like the next level where you did the whole challenge with the teams. And then they had like this big fucking dinosaur creature at the very end of it. So I don't know if that was like a teaser for what is Voyage 3 or not.
Mm.
But yeah, I'm assuming like in a lot of ways, like they're trying to ensure that people have fun, but they're also stress testing having that many concurrent players.
That's a lot of players. Hitting.
It is a lot. And I'm sure that they expected some throttling of their servers. But at this point, like when you have 6 months of development, my feeling was like you should be able to handle like millions of hits on your servers, especially given like how popular Yuga and Bored Apes are.
Yeah. they have infinite resources. So anything that doesn't go swimmingly is a structural fault, or it's a fixable problem, because it's not like they're lacking for resources or talent, you know?
Yep. So I'm sure they'll learn and they'll iterate. But I didn't actually get to like walk through the full tutorial.
I can't wait for the SpongeBob collab, dude.
It's coming.
Or the Bible Man. Dude, imagine Bible Man in
Bible Man dropping into Yuga.
Yeah.
Blasting you with the Lord.
Yeah, let's go. He's got a lightsaber.
Does he actually?
Yeah, he does.
Wow. That's something.
I'm telling you, man, he's the coolest.
And let me dig up the Animo updates while you show everyone Bible Man again.
Bible Man in Fortnite?
God.
Is that what
my
this is?
Goodness.
What were we going to talk about next? I cut you off and talked about how I don't like Bored Apes, and then
you're good. You're
we talked
good.
About Animo. Yeah, no, it's Treeverse, right?
Nah, I mean, I don't got anything for Treeverse, honestly. I don't think there's any major updates for Treeverse.
Nah,
but
fuck Treeverse, dude. I don't want to talk about them anyways.
Yeah, Loop, get at us. Drop in our DMs. We still love you.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So Animo, let's switch gears. Maybe you could pull up some of the tokens while I'm chatting through this, but
I'm busy.
Yeah, it's fair. That's fair. Very important stuff over here.
I'm doing stuff, dude. Trying to fit. Yo,
it's on the level of like, remember Howard Stern dropped into the VMAs
later Waldorf.
And he was like Fart Man or something like that.
Was that like Tom Green era?
Yeah, it was definitely Tom Green era. Okay. And like Howard Stern's ass cheeks were out, and then there's like they like play the sound effect of him just farting. Do you remember that?
I remember all the Tom Green antics with like the fake butt cheeks, but I don't remember Howard Stern very much.
Yeah, he was like Fart Man. It's giving me Fart Man vibes.
Okay.
I gotta look this up.
Okay.
Fartman VMAs.
Okay.
Yeah. There you go.
Nice.
Like, come on. Look at those. Look at those ham hocks.
How dare you? Oh, that's his actual butt, huh?
That's his ass. Yeah, that thing is hanging out. It's very controversial.
Oh, that's so funny.
Those are the good days, man. The golden era.
That's amazing. I don't want to look at this anymore, but also that's amazing.
Yeah. You don't want to do it. You don't want to look, but you also can't look away.
Tom Green Canterbury Tales. Later, by the way, Waldorf, thanks for being here, man.
He's Waldorf.
Tom Green Canterbury. Dude, Freddy Got Fingered is one of my favorite movies of all time.
I haven't seen it. Dude. Can you believe that?
Dude, it's...
I mean, I know.
It's a masterpiece.
Yeah, I know it's of its relevance in the era of its time.
It's so good, and it's not it holds up because it's a satire on the movie industry.
Okay.
Because Tom Green's like really, he's one of those guys that's really smart but just acts like a fool, you know?
Yeah.
I think the jackass guys are, or some of the jackass guys, like Johnny Knoxville is probably on that wave, you know?
Yeah, Sacha Baron Cohen.
Yep,
fits in that boat for sure.
Sure. So yeah, definitely watch it, man. I want to see what you think.
Yo, Steph needs us to hurry up. She's hungry.
Yo, then order the food.
I love that.
I want fish and chips. We're getting food from Storm and Norman's.
Ooh, what a name.
Yeah.
Dang.
Pretty good.
Well, let's wrap it up then for Steph. So we have one last update.
Yes.
Animo game updates. So this is in their Discord. And it says here, let me see, beta testing. We have a few milestones that are coming up shortly, and one of them is finishing a functioning beta model of the game for you all, holders, to playtest with us. We will give you more information in the upcoming days regarding dates when this will be finished, and we will post more information about playtesting windows. Currently, the plan is we will likely be to open up playtesting windows on weekends when it is ready for you all to play test. A lot of play test. They're the same place a lot. When it goes without saying, Yeah, I think there might be a play test that this is a beta version, meaning that there would be a lot of fine tuning.
Hold on. Storm in Norman's is closed.
No.
What do you want to eat then? What should we eat then? Red Robin?
Unlimited fries.
Dude, I love Red Robin.
Unlimited fries. I had a buddy that used to work there, and he was just like, you guys want some fries? Come on down. I'll give you unlimited
fries. They throw them out like they're dollar bills, dude. They everywhere.
It's unreal.
And I'm sorry to cut you off, but this is very important. And so
imagine the countries Red Robin could feed if they didn't throw out all their fries.
Dude, I was watching a survival show. So Steph and I have been watching survival shows a lot. And I'm this guy talking, saying, oh, he's eating like a rotten, like a half rotten cod or something. And he's like, some people would just kill to have this meal. And it's like, I don't think so, dude. I don't think there's anyone in the world that would kill to have a rotten cod at this point. Like,
is that the show on Netflix where they like, they drop them on a deserted island and they only give them like a couple of tools and they just have to like make it out there for weeks?
It's similar. Yeah. So there's like Naked and Afraid is a good one.
Okay. Gotcha.
They'd push them out into the Amazon with no clothes and like a knife and just say like, all right, we'll be back in a month.
Best of luck.
And then, but the one that
don't die.
You want zips? Okay. I'll take like a double bacon burger from Zips.
I'll take one too, Steph.
B-Bad gets it. Yeah, nice send one to Rye too. Well, Rye, what's your address?
Yeah. Live all right, on it is 6969, your mom's Ave.
That's just wasted money, man. That's unprofessional.
No, I'm serious. That's where I live.
No, really.
No, I'm serious.
I'm sorry, dude. I cut you off so much, and I'm sorry. So what?
You're good.
Let's finish the rest of the playtest. Animo news.
No, I'm talking to my real friends in chat, honestly. So we're fine. All right, Steph. Jesus.
Oh my God.
God damn it.
Women, dude. These women be like, unreal. I don't even have the password.
It's obviously 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
Good gracious, dude.
All right, you guys figure it out. You guys figure out your password. In the meantime, I'm going to read off the rest of this.
Okay.
Playtesting. It sounds like there's going to be playtesting, guys. All right. So the Animo's pretty affordable right now. If you want to go check that out, I really like it because it's this like tank shoot 'em up. And I love those types of games. And they've changed. I think they like partnered with a new company too. So like the play aspect, the view aspect has changed. It look, they posted some really fucking crazy. Yeah. You better be sorry, Steph. They posted some really crazy teasers lately. I knew it was password 69.
Oh fuck, that's not my Telegram, sorry.
It's out. So partnerships, they say, ooh wee, there's a lot of partnership discussions occurring right now. Can't spill too much alpha here because we need to finalize some details, but let's just say there's some exciting partnership discussions occurring. I also want to take the time to stress that we're planning on launching the game on PC, Mac, and consoles. And then in parentheses, he said Xbox, PlayStation, Switch, etc. So that is fucking awesome.
Wow.
That would be accessible everywhere.
What do you need to do in order to, because that seems big to me, right? What do you need to do to get on every platform? That's really rare for games to come out on all of them unless they've got a distributor.
I have no idea. Yeah, I know that they just partnered with some company that's helping them with the development of the game. So I'm assuming that there's some connections there,
cool.
But I'm not fully sure. They just released their like 3D collectibles too, which they turned out absolutely awesome.
Nice.
And they have dust mats. I think you pulled up the dust mats while you're scrolling through their Twitter. So I just love them.
That's what those were.
Yeah, exactly.
Those are cool.
I just love, there's like so cute, but they also have like so many different characters. And I know that they've said when we've had them on the stream before, you know, like you'll have the representation of your avatar, but then you'll also be able to sort of like piecemeal, the different, weapons. So I don't know if it's like reflective of your token one-to-one or if you can go into a garage and like modify, you know, the wheels, the tracks, the arms,
the guns, excuse me. But yeah, I mean, I just really like them. And I'm glad that they've been sticking with it too. Like, I think there's a lot of games that have been in development and then they hit the bear and they kind of disappeared. So
yeah,
they're one of those that have like really stuck through it.
It's impressive. It's super impressive. Because yeah, like they, I don't think Animo's ever gotten that wind of hype, you know?
It hasn't. I think they had like their initial drop didn't go well and they caught some heat because there was like some bugs. But how many other drops do we know that like didn't go well?
I know one.
They recovered.
I know a few.
Redacted.
Hey, shut up. Is that Peacock?
Yeah, man, they got a lot of cool shit.
To your point, though, man, it's admirable, and I love hearing that they've got that distribution success because that's huge. Yeah. Getting it on consoles and stuff, and
can't wait to play it on my Switch.
They're just good guys too. Anytime I've interacted with the Animo guys, it's always just a pleasure, you know.
Good people. So good people all around.
We should have them on stream again, maybe.
Yeah, let's do it. Let's fire it up.
Catch up.
That's all we got, guys. That's all we got for today. It was a light and easy one, but we're gonna start posting more, hopefully.
Dude, look at this frog in the. It's got like a laser sword.
I know there's a Habibi in there. I think there might even be a J838.
I know there's a Shaka one that's pretty sick.
That's true.
Here's the Habibi. Oh, it's like a PlayStation.
Look at those baddies.
Layout, that's sick.
So good, dude.
Yeah, man.
Actually, you could scoop those one of ones. Like, if you put in some offers, I'm sure there's some people that have been holding them for a long time that might bite.
Yeah, definitely.
One of those legs with the birds.
Yeah, that one's. I was just looking at that one. That's so good. Yeah, man. Well, this has been fun. This has been good.
I'm glad to hear it.
Well, do you not think so?
I didn't mean it like that. Well,
I love you, Rai. Yeah, it's been fun.
Good. I've had fun too. I'm glad we're back.
Same.
And I had fun too.
Yeah, I had fun too, I guess. Yeah. What'd you learn at school? Nothing. Gosh.
Nothing, Mom. Leave me alone. I just want to text my friends.
Yeah. Thank you guys all for showing up too. I know it's relatively short notice, but we're going to get back on the train. Seeing all these play tests, all these betas, all these alphas, everything is starting to kind of come to fruition. And so the content that we expected and wanted to do from the very beginning is now becoming a reality. So we're going to get back into it, and I'm going to dye my hair blue. Rye already has a blue hoodie, so he probably doesn't even need to do anything.
Probably match the beard up.
Dye your beard blue. Sub goal, everyone. I'm gonna put it on the stream. I need that text on the stream that just says like sub goal cut hair. Everyone seems to have that. And I wonder if
is that the new shit?
I wonder if it actually helps. Sub goal. Prank call Obama.
Let's find out.
Are you going on Twitch?
We're just trying to maximize our views.
El Bapo gets it. Thank you for that sub, El Bapo, by the way. Thanks, Jared. GG. All right, guys. Well, let's wrap it up so I can go feed my family with some delicious zips. A bucket of fries. Starving. All right, man. When are we going to be on next?
It's a good question.
I don't know. I don't want to commit on stream, but...
We used to do bi-weekly, so maybe we'll see everyone in 2 weeks.
No, thank you, dude. I'm straight weekly.
You only go weekly?
I only go straight weekly, dude.
Yeah, I mean, that's fair.
I don't do none of this liberal bullshit.
I'm just exploring myself. So maybe it's not for you. That's fine.
All right. Well, we'll keep you guys posted. Follow us. Talk to us on Discord. You know the drill.
Follow our new Twitter.
Yo, what's the new Twitter?
Cellar_GG.
Let me go to it. Yo, and you got the... Let's go. Following.
Bang, bang.
We already have 13 followers. Fuck yeah.
Yeah, a bunch of them are, like, definitely bots. I don't know where they came from.
We got botted already?
Yeah, I don't... I think I, like, put in the gaming, like, category, and then they came out of the woodworks.
let's keep it going, dude. That's how we get the Bored Ape level engagement.
That's it.
All right, guys, have a good one. Big round of applause for Rye. Big round of applause for honestly me, and we'll catch you later.
Later.
Where's the button? There's the button.
Hit the button.